Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're taking a look at a new app I just discovered called Godspeed. And Godspeed is a task manager that is really focused on these two things, speed and keyboard-driven navigation and everything. Basically, if you want a task manager that is completely controllable from your keyboard, this might be an interesting option for you. We'll take a look at some of the features here. We won't go through everything, but yeah, let me take a look at my Godspeed app and we can show you kind of some of the stuff that it does. So we're looking at my today view, which is very similar to Things's today view, which I really love. Just here are the things I need to do today, and I can navigate it with the arrow keys. I can use J and K to move up and down as well. That's kind of an old school computer navigation, like terminal level navigation thing, but you can do that. Probably get over to the items on the left, go over here with the left arrow, and then kind of arrow up and down and take a look at everything. So the today view is where I like to spend my time, and you can see I've got a few things to do today. I need to record my Godspeed video, need to water my desk plant, set up a checkup appointment with my doctor. I need to message someone at work about a task. So these are kind of what you would expect. And you can see I've got them assigned to different groups. So this is a better computer. These two are home things. This one's work. But let's get into the record Godspeed video here. So one thing you'll notice is that all over the interface are keyboard shortcuts. So over here on the right, when I have this task selected, E, D, S, R, all these things will do specific things. So if I want to change the do time for this, just hit D, brings up this little thing, and it uses natural language. So I can choose one of these if I want. But let's say in 1 hour is when I want to do this. So cool. That's when that's going to be due, an hour from now. But that's only one item. And I actually see over here, I have 18 items in a better computer. So what are these? So let's go into this. And so you can see up in the top right, Command G brings you to this list that I've created. So here we are on all the things I want to do for this video, and I basically have my outline in Godspeed so we can do it in real time and kind of use it as we'd expect. So entirely keyboard based. Yeah, I talked about this already, but yes, do not use this app if you don't want to use your keyboard. If you want to use mouse input for a lot of things, it's not good for that. So I've already talked about that. Spacebar marks things as complete, and you can see no frivolous animations. It just happens right away. That's a big thing for them. Now let's talk about the pricing. The pricing is something I like to bring up early in these. It's $8 a month, $72 a year, or $149 for a lifetime license to it. It also has a 14-day free trial, which I am currently on right now. You might notice over there in the right side, we have notes where I put those prices. I also have attachments, which I have a screenshot there. So if I hit A, you can see, oh, there's the screenshot of their pricing page. So you can take a look at that. Keep it forever, 18 months of updates. I actually didn't realize that, but yes. Yeah, I guess 18 months of updates if you get the one-time payment. So not technically a lifetime thing, but that's the pricing for it. It's a little expensive. I'll just say right now, I'm not going to subscribe to it after this video, but thought it was worth sharing because this might resonate with some people. So pricing, done. Now let's go into the app settings because this channel loves settings. So hit Command comma to go into the settings. And again, the keyboard shortcuts are everywhere. So 1, 2, 3, 4 to go to the main things. The main thing I want to show here is quick entry. So you can set a global hotkey. So wherever you are in your Mac, you can go ahead and start creating a new task. It defaults to something I find very confusing, so I don't use that. I set it to Command Option Control Space, which works really nicely for me. The other thing I'd recommend in here is there's some smart lists that it'll automatically show over in the sidebar. Today is not shown by default. So by default, you'll see upcoming and completed tasks, but your today view with the things you need to do today doesn't show. I recommend turning that on. I find it really useful. Also, there's hardcore mode, which disables mouse interaction, which forces you to use keyboard for everything, which you can do. You probably shouldn't. This is kind of a joke feature, honestly, I think, but it kind of speaks to the type of app that this is. There's some appearance settings. I haven't really messed with any of these, but yeah. So enable the today view, mention hardcore mode, universal new task entry, which I've changed to a different shortcut. So there's that. Settings, cool. Now, one thing I like to do in my task manager is create different areas of my life. So if I go over here, you can see, There we go. I have work tasks, I have home tasks, I have a better computer tasks, but there are other things I may want to do. So let's do a shopping list maybe. So to figure out how to do this, what's the keyboard shortcut? Let's navigate over. It's Command Shift N, and I'll show you how to find these a little later. But Command Shift N brings up a new list. And this is going to be a shopping list for me. I like to put a icon next to all of my lists that I do so I can kind of see them more easily. So shopping list. These are the things I want to buy. If I want to create a new item in here, I could do this. We'll do what I want to buy. iPad Air. Cool. So I want an iPad Air. Okay. How do I iPad Air. Here we go. Let's just put a link in there. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and copy this link. And if I want to add a note, I can actually hit N and then paste it in. Or I think I can actually just paste on top of a task that I've selected. And there you go. It adds it to this. And I actually don't want all this extra stuff. Just iPad Air. So there you go. So now I have this that I can just have attached to my tickets, or my tickets, my tasks. So there you go. What else do we have? Create lists. So yeah, you basically do that for whatever areas you have. Again, if you've watched my videos before, you know I like to have work, home, and then my side projects and shopping and a couple other things that might be useful. So let's mark that as complete with the mouse just because we can. We're not using hardcore mode. Switching between those views over on the left is pretty easy. So if you want to go to the today view, it would be command one to go to a better computer. I'm not quite sure. So hold down the command key and then you'll see the number next to each of those items in the sidebar to see what shortcut gets you there. So command one brings you to the today view. I think it was command seven brings me back to a better computer. So you can go ahead and jump between those pretty quickly. It would be kind of nice if those numbers were always there so you could more easily do it without having to think about it, but yeah. Okay, let's finally make a new task. So you saw me do it previously. If you're kind of just in one of these views, you can hit Command N to make a new task in that area, new thing, enter, and then you can use the keyboard shortcuts on the right to do things. So when it does natural text entries or natural language parsing, so we could say in 74 minutes, and that knows what is in 74 minutes. We could do tomorrow, and it does 8 a.m. Tomorrow, noon. So, right, so it can understand how due dates work. We could actually say today, 4 p.m., and then once you have a date on it, you can snooze it. So you can choose how to snooze. Natural language works here. And you can also repeat it. So how often do you want it to repeat? Weekly, monthly, yearly, or Mondays and Wednesdays at 3:30 p.m. Nope, that doesn't work. Mondays and Wednesdays. Okay, so best I can do is a couple days, Mondays and Wednesdays and Fridays. Yeah, so you can do multiple days throughout the week. If you want to do like exercise, you could have it every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So it's not every day. So repeating is pretty decent. You can also add labels. So if this is a thing I must do, I actually have a label called must do, or I could add a new label called might do. And then you can, of course, do all this from the keyboard. We'll make this kind of a green. There we go. And this one's going to be a might do. So there you go. Got that there. Attachments, hit A. You can paste a new attachment. Command Shift A. What does this do? Oh, this brings up your file picker. You can also just paste files in to here. So I think I have a screenshot. Yeah, so here's the screenshot I did a little while ago of the pricing. If I paste that in, it pastes it in to the task as an attachment. I can also, if I have text, you kind of saw this earlier, paste, and you can see it pastes that into the note. So if it's text on your clipboard, it pastes it as a note. If it's a file, it attaches it to the file. But this is just an example, so let's go ahead and just mark this as complete. And what else? So we showed the attachments. We can make a subtask. I didn't do that. So you might have noticed that create a task has a subtask here and then a subtask of that subtask. So let's go to the top level, make a new task called example. And let's make a new one here. And maybe this is a subtask of that first task. Hit tab. It tabs it under that. So thing one, thing two, and this is different thing. And so if I don't want this one to be under here, just shift tab, and that brings it out. So you can mark the top thing as complete, that marks everything complete, and we'll mark that one complete as well. One thing to note is that subtasks do not show as having the same due date. So this whole thing has a due date of today at 10:12 a.m., which means it shows in the today view, but the subtasks do not. So I can click into it. No, I can't. So I actually have to go to this view to see all of these subtasks, which is a little annoying. I also mentioned that I have a universal keyboard shortcut. So if I hit the keyboard shortcut here, that brings the app to the front with the quick entry. So something to do. What list do I want it to be in? Let's put this in the home one. When do I want it to be? The last time I used, in 1 hour, tomorrow, whatever. Let's do tomorrow. So tomorrow at 8 a.m. I can add some notes. I can paste in an attachment, but I'm just good. So we'll move it there. And you can see that it's been added. And if I go to my home, I should see something to do tomorrow at 8 a.m. So cool. A couple other things, and we'll kind of get to the wrap it up here. If you want to move items up and down this list, you actually can't drag with your mouse, which is a little weird. But you can hold the Option key, and in this view, you can just arrow up and down to move things up and down the list. You can also use K and J, which, again, I think I mentioned earlier, but that's kind of an old school way to move things up and down in interfaces. If you are in the sidebar, so let's say you've got this project selected, you can move up and down the list, but option arrows don't actually move it. You actually have to do K and J here, so you can organize those with the Option key. So, got that. And then mark it as complete. Oh yeah, and you've seen me doing this the whole time. When you mark a task as complete, use the spacebar. Finally, the one thing here, if you don't know the keyboard shortcuts for everything, if you don't see it visually on the screen, there's Command K, which lets you search for commands. So we could do new list, create new list, and it shows you the keyboard shortcut, but you can, of course, do that. One thing I didn't mention are smart lists. Again, this video has gone on a little longer, so we don't need it, but I have this smart list called Important Stuff, and basically you can create rules for this one. The label should have must in it. If I wanted to make a new one, I forgot the keyboard shortcut already, smart list, create a new smart list, low priority. And so this would be label might. Is that what I named that one? Must do, won't do. I marked it as complete, didn't I? Okay, so water my desk plant. Let's say the label on this is might do. So then low priority does show this. So I was able to create a smart list. Anyway, you don't need to do that necessarily. Let's go back here. But yeah, the command bar, command K, has all the things. So if you want to do something, how do we delete something, delete item, archive list, all those things, you can do that there. My final note is there is an iOS app. I installed it. It's not great. I would say definitely if you're looking at this app, you should look at the Mac version. It's available for Mac and iOS only. No Windows, no web, as far as I can tell, no Android. So if you have a Mac, I would recommend taking a look at it. It's worth a look. Again, 2-week free trial. But yeah, I don't know if it's going to be for everybody. We're going to mark this as complete. That's my video on Godspeed. Godspeed? Yes, geez. I've been away for a while, haven't done one of these. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.